My name is Carlin. Welcome to my channel. Disclaimer, disclaimer, disclaimer. Things you see me doing in my videos are probably not the best way you could do things. Sometimes I know better. Sometimes I will eventually learn about a better way. I don't go out of my way to be dangerous, though. So, if you see something, go ahead and mention it in the comments. I really do like the following sayings, even though they probably are cliché. Do what you can with what you have where you are. And from the military mindset, improvise, adapt, and overcome. Or, more recently, something I've been using a lot, fabricate or die. With all that said, the following video is a record of how I did something. You probably can do better. It's not my job to be here telling you how to do something, okay? You have been warned. On with the show.
I don't want to put these on the wall the same way, I don't think. Some of these I might. Also, it depends, like, if I want to do the wiring stuff over there. That's the nice thing about the French cleats, though, is I could build up a rack of just the wiring stuff. Like, this wouldn't go with wiring, so keep that separate. These aren't very good. That's pretty heavy, so, like, from here, these five would go together. Cut, strip, crimp. Yeah. And then maybe one or two of these. So, you know, I could make, you know, one, two, three blocks, something like that. Vice grips and stuff are more fixing stuff instead of electronics. So I've got so many knives now that I can find them all. Yeah, it's like some of these I'm just trying to get my head around what's a good way to store them. Also, like, I don't use these very much, so I don't want them on the wall if I don't use them all the time. And that's kind of what I'm thinking for wrenches and sockets. So what I had the idea a while ago of making flat trays to lay all the tools on and then pick the tray up, go to where you want to go, set it down. All right. So I'm kind of working through an idea for tool storage. Haven't got the budget right now to get the big snap-on toolbox I always thought I deserved. And unfortunately, I've worked in a few places where I've had one, so you get kind of spoiled. But what I was kind of playing with here, I was kind of thinking the idea of cafeteria trays, right? So just make a simple tray that you could put a few tools that matched on. And then for now, I'm just going to stack them up either up against the wall, you know, just have maybe two or three wide, two or three high. Just stack them so they aren't drawers, they're just trays. And then later make kind of a rack to hold them on, right? But for now, just I'm playing with the idea. This one is actually just a little bit too small. I'm going to make them, I'm going with an arbitrary 16 inches by 12 inches because I've already got shelves cut that are 48 inches by 16. So I can get four trays out of one of those shelves. And that just means I'm going to be short a couple shelves somewhere. But, you know, that's kind of how it goes. Okay, so that's one third of a 2x4. Or, you know, three cuts there. And then each of those I took a corner notch out of. And looks like I was just a little bit off on these because they didn't. Some of them dropped out and some didn't. Same diff. I'll probably save these offcuts for something anyway. I don't know if I really needed the edge on these, but I mean, the thing is, this is kind of like, I'm going to make one and just play with it a little bit first. Yeah, it's still 16 this way. It's just a little bit too small that way. It was kind of a scrap that I found. So the corners or the edges, it's mainly just to keep the tools from falling off. It's going to give it more strength, but I don't know if we need it anymore. And most of the hand tools are about that size. I don't know if I'm going to get completely crazy with screwdrivers and wrenches, but the pliers work good with this. I got pliers, strippers, crimpers, wire cutters, dykes, needle nose. You get the idea, right? Just taking the time to lay a bunch of tools out. See what did I have, how big it was. So one thing I might just look at is, as I go through building things, look for scraps that are about this size and then make two or three trays then, right? the tools that I use all the time, wire cutters, crimpers, strippers, and the flush cutters, like these for cutting off the zip ties, I might put those on the wall, but not everything else, right? You know, something like that, and you get the little baby vice grips. You know, maybe they could be with a separate group. Don't use these very often. That's a deep socket impact driver set, but that still fits within that profile, and I don't have to leave it on the plastic. The other thing I was just kind of thinking of is the depth. This one would stick up a little bit, but that's the only one. So if I can stack these one on top of the other, and then on the front, I could just sit there and label them sockets, right? So if I ended up with two or three sets of trays laying on the back edge of the bench, and this is kind of what I'm thinking, is when I'm working, I'll probably have two trays of tools just sitting there close by. Do what I need to do, and then put the tools back in the tray and then set it back out of the way. Okay. And this way I could just take the tray with me to wherever I'm working. You know, so if I end up with, for instance, I could specialize a tray. I could have one tray that's just the tools I need for the bicycles. All right. Part of the other reason for having the edges then is that the next tray could sit on top of it. That went so well, I wish I would have turned the camera on. Oops. This is the one I'm going to use the least often. Looking at all the tools that I wouldn't use as much, right? I glued it and brad nailed it from the bottom, smooth side up, rough side down. As it is, if it's sitting down, there's no weight on the board because it's pushed down flat, okay? And then you've got enough grip on the edge to just pick it up, so I don't need handles. I was thinking about that. I don't want it to be any higher than it has to be. I just was thinking about it. Nothing should hit. Yeah, okay, so we're good there. Nothing sticks up higher than the top of these. So basically the next one would just sit down on top, and then I would just mark these, probably just Sharpie pliers. Done, right? Eventually I could see making kind of a stand with, you know, like a rack. What I really wanted to do, and I think I've seen them at Granger, I think was where I saw them. Cafeteria trays. This either the ones I saw were the fiberglass trays. You can buy them in a, I don't know, 24 pack or something like that, and then you get the tray holder, the rack that they all fit in. And I'm like, that would be the perfect solution for this. And then later on, I'd come back with my new set of tools and whatever I'm working on. So there could be, like, for instance, if I was soldering something, I could have one of these trays with all the soldering iron and stuff on it. So, you know, it could be, and when you're working, you could spread it out, but then you'd put it back on there again. Okay, so you could have your soldering iron, your solder, your flux, maybe a little magic holding hands thing that would hold the part for you or something like that, your magnifying glass because you're getting old and you can't see anymore. All that good stuff, okay. When you're done, put it all back on the tray, put it back somewhere else. It seems like I never get a project finished on the first day, but I need that bench space for something else, and so I end up just pushing everything out of the way. Yeah, I think I like the idea. I don't want to make a bunch of changes to it. I'm just trying to decide, is there anything, you know, I just left these ones short because these were the offcuts of these ones. And I don't know that I really need to close up the sides. Maybe I'll make these ones shorter on purpose because, you know, I'm not going to be... You know, I could pick this up and walk around the house and not feel like I was going to lose anything. All right. I don't need to have clips everywhere so that nothing moves, you know. Yeah, these don't have to have watertight seams or anything, so. It's like 90 degrees in here. Well, it is April. I guess it's time to get warm. Actually even working. I realize these work actually better for this kind of thing because I can just hit them really quick. I'm just using really short brads. once the glue dries, it's going to be pretty solid anyway, so it's got enough tack on the glue to hold it while I get it set. Kind of squaring it to the edge of the workbench, but not really. That's good enough. Quick look, make sure I didn't have anything come out. That's as good as it's going to get. Okay, honestly, these fell together pretty quickly because I had mostly pre-sorted the tools already. Not all done. I ran out of the cut 2x4 pieces, but that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 done. I've got a couple different sizes, it looks like. When I cut the OSB, it was a 5-foot shelf, so I cut it at 12 inches, 12, 12, 12, 12. The last one's about half an inch short because of the saw cut. The end one has sockets, and these stick up a little bit too high, so I couldn't stack something on top of that. All right, so we'll skip that one. But the rest of these, see, those are the small ones. I'm not thinking about any rhyme or reason right now. I kind of just threw everything in there. Some of these don't have sides on them yet. That one's crooked. Oh, that might be sticking up. Okay, so a couple tools are too high. I could make higher sides. That would be fine. Just a thing. That's better. Wire strippers are too big. Not the end of the world. Those will be something I want to use. I might have a couple trays that just stay out all the time. All right. Going into this, I was like, I should make one or two and stop, right? And then just kind of see what you learn in the process. Mostly I like it. It's simple. That's the idea. But I could have them all stacked up on one end. Like, for instance, let's say I decided to build a little model airplane back here. I would use none of that. I would use, you know, hot glue and X-Acto blades, straight edges, that kind of stuff, right? So none of that would get used. So I could stack them all up, push them onto one end of the bench, and then that would free up most of the bench. Okay. So we just kind of grab it. Take one tray as you need it. And the trays themselves really aren't very heavy, so it's easy enough to just take the one you want. You know, that's kind of funny. Yeah, that's too high. I think these are too high. Touch, but they're not. Yeah, they're just enough. All right. Find a new home for that. Something like that. Smooth side in, just maybe it'll ride a little better. Thank you.
that's a heck of a lot easier. You know, so I can just reach in. It ain't perfect, but I do that once when I pull it out, once when I put it in. Not every day. It's not worth putting proper wheels on it for that. Yeah, they don't roll perfectly straight, apparently. You know, maybe I didn't get them quite lined up. But for once in a while, I think that's all right. So I think, you know, for now, that's one of those quick and easy things. I made that all out of offcuts. Little weird tip and trick for you there.